Meet the HomePod, Apple's entry into the smart speaker market. Not only does it use spatial awareness to fill your room with high-quality sound, but you also get Siri to help you play that music and hopefully to help you answer some questions.
I don't have the answer to that. Is there something else I can help you with?
Hey Siri, read my message.
It says, Kelsia, I've never seen anyone party that hard. I hope you're okay today, clown face. Would you like to reply?
We all know why we're really here. Let's tear this thing down. How do we even start to get inside this thing? I don't know, but let's bring some heat and start from the top and work our way down. We heat up the touchscreen a bit and it pries right up, and then we remove some torch screws. And we'll heat up the next layer too, which lets us pry that right up, and we're met with the first PCB. I'm gonna pull out the heat gun to heat up the rubber foot a bit, and that lets me pull it right off, and we're met with even more torque screws. We'll take off the torque screws securing the drawstring first, and then we can go ahead and slide off the mesh. The 3D mesh is actually really interesting. It consists of a net-like layer at the top and a bunch of tiny coils in between. This type of construction allows sound waves to pass through the fabric with little to no reflection, but it still keeps the dust out. Four more screws hold the logic board in place, so we'll take those out. And with the flick of the spudger, we can lift out the logic board and see that A8 processor. There's 9 more hidden torque screws underneath all of these rubber stoppers, but even with all those out, we're still not any closer to getting inside. But we'll start at one of the seams next. Heating and prying doesn't work, our adhesive remover started melting the plastic, and our efforts at brute force resulted in us breaking it. So I guess it's time to bust out the ultrasonic cutter. Well, that was fun, but seriously messy, and I'm not sure how crystal clear the sound on this HomePod will be when we put it back together, but we'll let you know. There's 6 more torque screws holding the woofer in place, and you can feel that heavy magnet on the backside of the woofer as you lift it out. Disconnecting the woofer gets us our first real glimpse inside, and there is still so much more left to tear down. 6 more screws hold a ring secured to the base, and below that we've got another interesting find, another threaded ring. We're thinking that at some point the HomePod was able to be unscrewed to separate the woofer component and the tweeter power supply unit, but judging by the adhesive we've been battling, the threads aren't meant to be engaged by the consumer. This thing was glued shut, which is probably why the AppleCare repair cost is 85% of the cost of the device itself. We're left with a pile of boards stacked on top of each other, and the first to come out is part 1 of a 2-part power supply, which handles the AC-DC conversion, followed by the capacitor-studded outer ring. There's a small board glued to the side of the barrel that's home to a microphone that is likely a low-frequency mic that handles the woofer calibration. The HomePod is also listening and adjusting the bass level in line with other frequencies. The rest of the microphones can be seen firmly glued around the center of the HomePod, all with their own window to the outside world. Lastly, we free one of the 7 tightly packed-in tweeters, all crowned with 2 golden posts that are, you guessed right, delivering power to the speakers. With the HomePod completely disassembled, it's time to talk repairability. The HomePod scored a 1 out of 10, and here's why. On the upside, the HomePod is built like a tank, so durability should not be an issue. The outer fabric mesh, despite lack of seams, can be peeled off undamaged thanks to a wicked cool drawstring. All threaded fasteners are of the same standard Torx variety, so no annoying security screws here. Extremely clever use of the conductive screw posts minimizes the cabling mess around multiple stacked layers of components. But on the downside, very strong adhesives secured the touch input cover, microphone array, rubber foot, and most annoyingly, the main point of entry on the top of the device, which otherwise looks designed to twist off without much fuss. And even though it looks like there ought to be a non-destructive way inside, we failed to decode it. Without a repair manual, your odds of success are slim. That's all for this teardown. Be sure to hit that subscribe button and follow us on Facebook and Twitter so you can be the first person to see our teardowns and latest repair videos. And I take apart cool stuff every week, so be sure to follow me on Twitter @KelseyFixes, and I'll see you next time.